You would have seen on the news, pretty much everyone who comes into New Zealand must self-isolate.
That includes Kiwis coming home from overseas. 14 days in semi-solitary confinement with the family. Soon, we're with a mum of three who just got back from Dubai. But first, here's Tim Wilson.
Our biggest airport, once a place of hustle and bustle, has become a ghost town of face masks and fear.
There's a lot of backpackers, and maybe if I'm them, maybe I wouldn't think it as, you know, I come from a doctor background. My mum's a doctor, my brother's a doctor, so I'm going to definitely do it. We are definitely doing it, but I'm not sure if everyone will.
From backpackers, confusion, resignation, and not self-isolating until check-in time.
After the check-in, we're just going to go in our room for 14 days.
On a day that Air New Zealand dropped 85% of overseas flights. International arrivals, usually this is a busy thoroughfare. Today, not quite so much. And at the airport car park, it's the same story. Kiwis coming home talking of last-minute departures. Kiwis like Ellen Cross and her three kids now trading Dubai for self-isolation.
We tried to get on the early flight. We couldn't make it, so we've missed that cut-off by 11 hours, which is pretty tough, actually. But I think it's fair.
After being picked up, it's back to Ellen's mum's place to weather the COVID-19 storm.
And Ellen's with us on Skype from her mum's. Thanks for talking to us, Ellen. You've flown halfway around the world to be here. Why did you come home?
Well, I've been in Dubai a long time, and all of a sudden things changed. Schools closed. Everything started closing, cinemas, parks, and it was questionable whether we could get out. Oman has closed its borders, so I wanted to get home. I wanted to be able to get in. And although we made it, we got the cut-off by 10 hours to have this self-enforced quarantine. So we're here, but we're indoors. So, yeah.
And how hard is self-isolation?
Well, you know what? I thought it was going to be a real nightmare, but we came in, everyone was really nice about it. We did have to sign forms. There wasn't a declaration. It was simply, where are you going to be? It was just opening everyone's eyes to what you had to do. I made sure my mum had bulk stocks of wine, so I have everything I need here. Toilet paper wasn't an issue, so it's not so bad. My mum has been able to go out. You're allowed to have family members who can go out and get food. That's not an issue. So it's not too bad. We can do it.
And is your mum able to check in with you guys? I know that she can go and get you food, so does she have to keep her distance, though?
No, well, what they say is, look, she's allowed to be here and she's here. I mean, she is a boomer. She's over 70, so she has to watch out a bit, but she was very happy to be here with us. She's a doctor, so she knows, you know, we're not going to be hugging all the time. We have to keep our distance, but no, she's with us, so we're okay.
Great stuff. Well, thank you so much for talking to us, Ellen. Take care. And I hope the self-isolation goes okay.
Yeah, I'm sure it will, but thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Enjoy that wine.
I'm going to. Already started.
Bye.
See you, Ellen.
Bye.
ASB and 7 Sharp, keeping you one step ahead.
That is certainly one way to pass the time if you are in self-isolation. Hit the wines.
Yeah. Well, I was in the supermarket yesterday and a lot of people panicked buying wine.
Were they really?
Oh, wine. I've never seen supermarkets so busy. It's very much like the pre-Christmas rush.
Yeah.
And I was told that Saturday was insane as well, and today as well. People seem to be buying a little less toilet paper. I did notice that there seemed to be enough toilet paper, but I've never seen supermarkets so busy, you know, for this time of year anyway.
Well, I mean, you can understand why people do want to stock up, because things have ramped up, obviously, over the weekend, and it's getting pretty serious. But we won't run out of food. We have been assured it'll be OK. And other people can drop you off food if you need it. I'm happy to drop off wine supplies too. If anyone's in self-isolation and they need some wine, seriously, email the show. I will drop it off myself, because you definitely have to have some. Quite interesting, though, at different parts of the world, including Australia, the supermarkets are having a specific hour for the elderly and immunocompromised to go shopping, which I think is a fantastic idea.
Yeah.
So they don't have to be around other people who might be spreaders of the virus. Mm-hmm. They can just make sure that they're, you know, around other elderly and not too many people.
Yeah, well, I'd like to see... It would be interesting if that happened actually in New Zealand. And I want to know a good time to shop, actually, because obviously if you do want to shop at night, there'd be a whole lot less people. I mean, this is during the middle of the day, though, so you wouldn't have thought there were a whole lot of people shopping at this time.
Yeah.
But yeah, you think that maybe a little bit later at night. But sometimes when you go a little bit later at night, the shelves aren't stocked. So
true. Mm. But rest assured, we're not going to run out of food.